Hello world, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome back to Robothot Zero to Hero series Python Machine Learning on the Edge. Alright guys, we are on lesson number 32 and we are going to learn about cleaning the data in Python Panda for machine learning purpose. Alright guys, cleaning the data is a very important aspect of machine learning programs. Alright, you get a bunch of data and you got to clean it, right? You get trillions and millions and trillions of sets of data, and you just cannot load everything. There has to be some systematic way to clean, slice and dice, right? So how do you clean it? What is that cleaning all about? So basically guys, cleaning the data means fixing bad data in your data sets. That means the bad data set could be any kind of empty cells within your rows and columns. There will be empty cells without any data. So that is an example of bad data, right? And data in wrong format. Sometimes the formats are messed up, right? That is another example. Sometimes the data itself is wrong in some of the cells, right? So that is another example. Sometimes, you know, there'll be duplicates of the same data. So that is a classic example. So in this particular lesson, I'll show you how empty cells can potentially give you a wrong result when you analyze the data, right? It's very risky guys, and it's a little tricky as well. One way to deal with the empty cell is to remove the row itself that contains the empty cells. And this is usually, sometimes it is okay, but since the data sets are very, very big, right? Removing one or two cells hardly makes any difference, or probably no difference at all, right? So let me show you an example how this works. So let me get into my Jetson Nano, and I am already logged into my Jetson Nano. Right, let's do some coding guys in Python Visual Studio IDE. Let's import, let me make this as a bigger screen, and let me, all right, import pandas as pd, space, enter, our data frame df equals pd pandas dot read underscore csv, and you get it in the drop down underscore csv. And remember the path guys, you should remember the path of the file where you stored, and my path, I just copied it. I showed you how to do that, so it should be very easy. All right, this is the path of my file, and my file name is data.csv, like that. All right, and then what we need to do is we need to create, use this file, and we need to use a method called drop na, right? So na is not applicable. Say new underscore data frame equals to df dot drop na. Okay, this is how the method works, and you need to open the bracket and close the bracket for any method or function when you are calling, right? That's very important. And then let us print new underscore df, and you get it in the drop down new underscore df dot to underscore string. Okay, and this is the way we are converting that, by removing, extracting the file. Now let's see what happens. So by default, the drop na with open bracket and a close bracket method returns a new data frame. You use the .csv file which is already existing, and you convert that so that you start cleaning up some of the messes, right? And that returns a new data frame, and that will not change the original. The original will remain as it is. You get a new one. Now let me run this program and see what happens. Run, right click, run Python file in terminal, And there you go. So this is our new data frame from the existing data frame. So can you see that, guys? All those, the entire data of duration, pulse, max pulse, calories, everything is there in the data file, in the CSV file. And you get this as a new frame, new data frame. All right. Now what we can do is, we can basically try to replace some of the, for example, if you want to change the original data frame, you need to use the in place equal to true argument. It's a method, it's an argument, right? So what we can do is, let me remove these two lines and let our CSV file remain same. Let's say df dot drop na, and then we need to use the method in place, okay, in place equals to true, like that. All right, and then print data frame dot to underscore string, and then close, use the open and close parenthesis for any function like this. All right, now let's run the program and see what happens. Right click, run Python file in terminal, and there you go, I got the output pretty clear. And let's go to the top of the row, and you get the duration, pulse, max pulse, calories. And this is how we do it, guys. It's pretty simple, and it's like, you know, playing around with the data. Now in the next lesson, I am going to show you how you can replace the empty values in Python Panda, right? It's pretty easy. I'm going to show you some of the methods and functions, and you will really enjoy that. Until then, see you soon. Give me a thumbs up, and if you have any questions, do leave me a comment. I will respond to you back. All right, guys, see you until then. Bye-bye.